Green, Colorado. All right, Carson, stand there. Hit it, get ready to knock it. Hit it, you may have to. Oh, so close. Hit it, Carson, you can do it. Oh, this is good. Come on, buddy. Oh, so close. You're there. All right, here we go. We are practicing.
All right, so we're going to
say
these rows.
Brooklyn, all right? Brooklyn, are you ready? RD, are you ready? Did you get wet, RD? Are you okay? Are you ready to hit it?
Yeah.
Ready? Here we go. Here we go. Oh, Brooklyn's so close. Good. You're going to get it. Hit it, she hit it! Fun way to start Weather and Science Day. Oh, look at this in our replay. Looks great. It's fun to be able to use this kind of platform to be able to see some big science experiments, and that's why we want to introduce our next guest. Ladies and gentlemen, from the Estes Rockets, please welcome Mike Fritz. Join us on stage, Mike.
Always.
Oh, here he is. Hi, Mike. How are you? We have a microphone for you right here. It's great to have you up here.
Thanks. It's great to be here.
Talk to us a little bit about rocketry here. There's a lot to know about rocketry. Tell me about that.
Estes has brought two parts of our presentation today. One is to show an experiment showing explaining Newton's second law of motion, where you have force, mass, and acceleration. We've taken model rockets, put the same rocket engine in. The weight is different, so what's going to change is how high the rockets go.
So you were telling us that there's a formula. Take a look at the graphic right up here. Force equals mass times acceleration. So you know that if we have an experiment, we can only change one variable. So what's the one variable that we're going to change over here in the rockets? Take a look at the four rockets that we have over here.
If you look at the rockets we brought, there's a large one, a medium one, and a small one. So they all weigh different. The question is, if the four...